guys, this is the Starsky and Hutch video game. So just waiting for it to load. And this is a real special treat, because I haven't played this game since Blockbuster is around. So this will be interesting to play this again for a review. And there's a nice little intro I want to show you guys, which is pretty cool. It's kind of like the TV show. This is based on the 1970s TV show. Obviously, you got free roam, which you can do what you want. TV specials, which I haven't unlocked yet. I'm currently working on unlocking them. Obviously, different profiles. Got the options. Locker to play different little clips, the little cutscenes. Season 1. Okay. We'll start with Season 1, Episode 1, or work our way up to the episodes. I got the subtitles on, that way you guys can hear that way you can see what they're saying. Since I had to keep the sound off, obviously for ASMR purposes, but also so YouTube doesn't copyright infringement, and you know, some reason we do that, you know, sometimes it can cause that, you know, issue. Certain ways you have to do it, so I just keep it silent. But it's also ASMR, so you know, it'll take away from the, you know, effect of ASMR to have, you know, the sound of that. So, and I just give you my objective. Speeding stolen car is causing mayhem on the streets of Bay City. Stop the blue suspect coupe by any means. Destroy 20 cardboard boxes, which you don't have to do. It's just if you're able to. And it shows a little point system and the advantages you get. Of course, I tried to do the cover boxes, but it's a bit tough. And this one's getting pretty fun. You get to drive the Ford Gran Turismo and from the actual TV show. And there it's a car we're chasing, a 1970 Plymouth Hemi-Cuda. And you get the driver's card, and you get to play a Starsky and Hutch. And you have to, as you can tell, you have to shoot the car and take it out. And they give you little bonuses. It's a really fun game. Change to shoot the stop sign. The intersection light. It's like traffic keep flowing. Drifting, do a little bit of drifting, which is kind of fun. You always want to shoot those. Those give you extra time. I can see the number went up. That's your time limit that you have in order to stop the suspect. That's a really fun game. And it takes place in the 70s, just like a TV show. So it's really lots of fun. Really nice cutscenes that they have. And of course, for someone like me, I'm always watching classic American television. You know, Bonanza, Gunsmoke, Beverly Hillbillies, you know, Dukes of Hazzard. And that's what I'm working on getting next, actually. They actually have a Dukes of Hazzard video game, which I'm definitely going to be getting to. A nice jump, too, just like the Dukes of Hazzard jump. As I call it. I'm working on getting the Hazard game, which I don't have yet, but I definitely would do that for a video. I've seen that on TikTok and YouTube. It looks like a really fun game. Okay, here we go. Back to the game. So yes, I'm just chasing them. There's different things, targets to shoot. Do another jump for you guys. I'll screw that preferably. I said you could do different jumps like that, which just makes it really fun. It makes it a lot like the TV show. It kind of gives you the feel like you're in the 70s. Which I, ah, crap. And of course I missed the little jump, lever jump. I'll hopefully come back around, I'll try to get to it. Usually I notice all the jumps. So it can be a little hard at first because you have to drive and shoot at the same time to stop the current, you know, said suspect. And you get a nice little turbo boost once you see the shit once in a while into the car to reduce their health, to stop the suspect. But it's not something you want to do constantly, non-stop. Unless you want to, you know, destroy your vehicle and then pretty much fail the mission. Why, this is cool too. I never, low cut scene, you shoot the stars and it's what they call a special event. Bam! Right into the car. So you get interesting little, like, TV special kind of little TV shots like that. And the cool jumps and action scenes, which is pretty cool. And that adds more to the game. And I'm kind of playing it too. Like, it kind of feels like I'm actually in, like, you know, the Starsky and Hutch TV show. You know, it's really fun, really realistic feeling to it. And of course, you have to shoot nonstop, which is what I've been playing since, you know, Blockbuster, since I was a kid. But, I ran it from Blockbuster probably at least, like, 5 or 6 times back in the day. This isn't a copy from Blockbuster, though. Real quick, here's another awesome shot. Car jump right through a business building. Man, look at that. That's cool. And of course, there goes my hood. Uh-oh. Oops. Yeah, you know what? I just did an excellent crash into the cars. That'll lower your time limit. So definitely, but you're shooting the car actually adds time to it, so you can't make up for it by shooting the hell out of the car. What you're supposed to do anyway to stop the suspects, that'll stop fleeing a police custody. Same jump as before, but it's still pretty cool. And surprisingly, I actually never got 10 points for a jump. That's actually the first time, so that's pretty good too. I said that it takes a while to shoot because the health goes down just a little bit, maybe a little bit. And that wasn't supposed to happen. the next mission, season episode 2, is pretty fun too. You gotta do a van. Stop them before they reach the city limits. There's never, I could have done that a little bit better. That was, but, yeah, I was supposed to do better than that, go flying all over cars, but that one's really hard. I always have a problem doing that one. But, you know, I thought I'd give it a try anyway for you guys. So they'll be pulled over soon. So all you do is crash into them and knock them to the side, and that gets them to stop too. And you get a cutscene real quick. Because now, since they caught the bad guy who stole the car for who knows what reason. Like I said, it's based on the TV show. So obviously everything's gonna look more, you know, outdated or old. play the next episode. Episode 2 was pretty fun. As a kid, I had a hard time beating it, but as an adult, I was like, oh, why did I have a problem with this as a kid? Episode 2 was so easy. The one episode here that's hard is episode 5. I have to look, it's either 4 or 5, but I think it's episode 5. I'm having a bit issues with from almost beating it, but I keep but not good enough, because you have to shoot one on one car, and you have to keep one car's health alive without exploding, and I always get so close to beating the mission. I'm hoping I get that, you know, soon, can beat it soon. There's a heist in the BC bank to prevent the getaway van from reaching the city limits. Suspects are armed and dangerous. Getting close to where my phone won't let me record much longer, so I probably won't be able to record the whole thing. But, you know, I'll try to show some cool shots and everything, and gameplay as much as I can. If I can, I'll try to shoot the whole thing, but I don't know if I'll be able to finish the mission in time. Kind of like I may or may not, but I'll give it a try. That's a car you drive. little boost. If I could hurry up and get to the bank, change the light for everybody. That way they can go, they could flow through. A special event thing. More action packed. And hopefully the fire department in the game comes. This is harder because they have shotguns in the back that they're going to shoot me with, which will give you less time. That will affect your car's health. So you definitely want to shoot these shields. That'll help to keep your car from getting destroyed as quickly. Usually I can do this with like little damage. I don't want to try to run people over because that'll give you less time too. This part is pretty simple. You just gotta shoot the bad guys until you shoot down the gunners. Once you shoot the guys with the guns and take them out, then the van is no longer deadly, and you can easily, you know, go for this level. And of course, you got these two knuckleheads who are trying to stop you. They don't want you. They're working with the van because they want to protect, you know, they want to protect their people. So they can get away with the crime, which of course you can't allow. And of course they'll purposely try to run you off the road on purpose just to start stuff and keep you from from getting the van. I just shoot these.